Hey guys, today we're here in West Central Ohio on a farm. This was a blank slate just a few months ago. We're going to talk about I want to really touch on why we put this where it's at, right? This was just a blank slate. There's 25 acre swath through here, not very big at all, but we really wanted to create something to really control the deer movement and put them where we want them, when we want them, and how we want them. So this whole entire farm was just multiflora rows, you know, tag alders, honeysuckle, just an absolute mess, right? So we came in here a couple months ago. It's May 11th now. I think we come in here in February, March, somewhere in that time frame. Brought a forestry mulcher in, blew an access trail in on this whole north end running east and west, because here in West Central Ohio, a lot of the winds are like west, southwest, and south. So we obviously want these deer not to know we're hunting them. So that being said, we came in here with the forestry mulcher and blew about an acre and a half plot off of this pipeline out of those hardwoods to really kind of transition these deer from really greens to grains. So that being said, you always want to kind of feed them forward, right? On the architecture side, like I said, we come in, we're on the north corridor running east and west. We put a Banks blind right here and we're hunting these predominantly south and southwest and west winds. Like the tractor's coming straight north right now. So it's just perfect for these deer feeding them forward to these bag ag fields. All right, on this particular plot, what I like to do personally, I've been doing for years, is perennial clover, preferably white ladino is my favorite. And also I covered in a spring oats. We usually like to do a spring planting on establishing a new plot because you've got the entire growing season to really get that thing get off to a good start, right? So the clover is temperamental. If we get hot, dry months in the summer, it can get burned up, especially on a big open area like this. So I like to use the oats as a cover crop. It does a number of things, but the biggest thing is it holds moisture, it provides shade and cover, and also there's a little bit there for the deer to peck on as well, because a new plot like this, this area in particular, there's a ton of deer here, right? So, you know, this we're only talking about an acre and a half, so they could smoke this thing in no time flat when they're heading out here to these beans on a summer night. You know, we come in here, like I said, this was a blank slate. We had the whole farm to work with, but I chose to lay it out the way I did, a little bit of food plot architecture, which you hear that all the time. You know, we're bow hunting this farm predominantly, right? So we want to keep these deer in range, but we want to widen this thing out as much as we can within archery range. You know, we're not in here going to expect to gun hunt and shoot 200 yards down this power line. This is a really a bow setup, and I chose to kind of bottleneck it and make it almost like a big bowling, like a bowling pin almost, like toward the blind. So it gives a lot of tonnage close to the blind. And then we got the long strip, like I said, just kind of feeding them forward out of that timber, you know, from bed to feed. You know, one thing we want to add to this plot, like we said, we don't want a big deer to come out way down there 300 yards away and be able to look through here for 300 yards, right? So whitetails love edge. So we're going to add some screening in here. And one thing we're going to use this year, because this is going to be a permanent plot for us, we're going to use it year in and year out, we're going to use giant miscanthus grass. I've been using it for the past couple years, put probably 20,000 rhizomes in the ground last year, and phenomenal, did a great job for us, you know. We want to keep these deer from, you know, looking all the way down across here, and then we also want to try and influence their movement. Instead of walking through the wall, we want to make them walk around the wall, and we can do that as simple with a screen. Really think about, if you're going to spend the time, the money, the effort, etc., really think about ways you can influence deer movement. It does not take as much as what people think. It can be as simple as a snow fence, some old fencing you're throwing away from your yard project. It can be even hinge cutting in the timber. You know, I've used about just everything out there, I've used it, right? So really think about ways to influence those deer and how you can get them and put them where you want them and, you know, and how you want them. Specifically bow hunting, you know, you got a small plot like this, like we said, try and put that wall or that screen or that hinge or whatever you're using, that fencing, try and put it to where you're gonna have those deer in bow range. That's the whole purpose, right? So just try and get those deer where you want them and get them close to you for a good archery shot.